aided. Grace of God is too much in this place and is locating people everywhere. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, glory, glory, glory.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Sister Mutuze, zina lanu, kume nye mkuchoki la kumasu maomboni.
Zina anga ni Edith Sabato.
My name is Edith Sabato.
Umakabu, station 2,
Esco. I'm staying at Esco, station 2.
Umbonu anga, na kwenye na ubano.
Here goes my testimony. I just want to thank God for what he has done to my life. And my faith upon God. My husband stopped working in October. All this time from October, I've been cooking magwinya. At least you know magwinya. Everybody knows magwinya. Because I'm also not working. Where I'm staying, of course it's cheap. We are paying 600. But with my business, that was a lot of money. And I was having a lot of stress that how will I get the money to pay rent? My husband was home and I was alone and I was thinking what to do. How will I survive? And around that area, that business of magwinya is not that business which brings a lot of money. I was just selling 50 rand maybe a day. Despite my situation, I stood strong before the throne of God because of the anointing under our Papa, because of the blessings in this house. I didn't even think of going back, but to trust God for my situation.
My sister, Tatuzani. Muta yamba ubena guno, muta yamba kukuru pilila. Moyo wano, uwasinta kwanji.
Matame na yamba ubena guno, nisalami. Nyeu mabepe ya hindi masuwa pila wanasuma kuzi na
mwana. The time I was coming here, I was in prayer, but I was not stronger than this time because of this house, because of this grace and anointing. But because of this anointing, I can feel the grace, I can feel the favor in my life.
Tatuzani, moyo wano utasintika ndimene muta yamba kubwera kuno. Timamva mumatiuza za business yanu iyasintha motani.
Business yanga muzi wa magwinya waenda chikona kwabira kuchilo kumaso ana school abira ku school.
You know that business of magwinya is a morning business when people are going to work or people are going to school in the morning. It was the second week of December. I was just having 200. The people were not buying. If I cook, they were just rotting and I was going to throw them away. But I stood strong before God. It was on the 30th of December when my husband came back from home, Malawi. He found me with a
team.
And he asked me, what type of business were you doing all this time, having 200 all this time? And I told him with belief that this is a lot of money. And he asked me, how are we going to pay rent with this money? I said, don't be wallet, God is having more grace upon us.
Amen.
I inquired from a lot of people to change my business, but people were jealous of me. They did tell me how to do the other businesses. I inquired and found a sister in the same church. Her name is Morini. She's the one who directed me about that business.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When the world denies you,
oh, yes,
God will not deny you.
Oh, yes.
Our sister was denied by the world.
Oh,
they
yes.
couldn't show her where to go.
Oh, yes.
But God located her through another sister. Hallelujah.
Amen. I stocked 2 kg, 2 packets of 5 kgs. And in my house, I don't have a fridge. I kept by my neighbor's place. Those things got rotten again. I just sell 5 kg. The other 5 kg was rotten. I started crying for my situation. Because this January, I have to send money home. Then I stopped crying before I remembered God. Because I'm a daughter of the anointed prophet Papa Jonah, I stopped crying and trusted God. I started praying.
It was
last Friday. I found the money to
glory to Jesus.
When I was going to my landlord, I went there with a 600. But I kept that 100 rand from 600 so that it can help us in the house. But when I went to my landlord, I didn't believe what happened. My landlord is a good landlord, but on money issues, he's not a friend at all. When I was giving him the money, I remember on April he said you start paying 700. I reminded my landlord that yes, you told me about 700, but with my situation I can't afford to pay 700. But the landlord replied to me, said, why are you worried, my daughter? I did tell you to give me money. You are not supposed to pay rent.
Jesus.
What a wonderful God.
Amen.
You are supposed to pay the money when your husband starts working. What a testimony. What a wonderful God we serve. But that woman is an old woman and is also sick. But he's not working for
sick.
I felt sorry and I insisted to that old woman, take this money. And the old woman insisted, no, it's a blessing to you. At last she said, just give me a 200 out of 600 to pay rent. What grace, what anointing, what a wonderful God. Oh yes.
Hallelujah. My sister, the grace of God upon your life has been speaking for your situation.
Oh, yes.
To the point that the landlord say, my daughter, do you are not supposed to pay the rent?
Oh, yes.
What can you advise viewers all over the world where they are watching us and they are in the same situation of you as we are talking now? Someone is saying, I don't have anything to give to my landlord. Mutu amene yoyo, muga muze mawotani, pachimene iniyo mawona, diposo makrubilida pamaloano.
In the end, you're going to have to
I just want to encourage you. Sometimes, even when we are in that situation, we need to stand strong before God. Because when God wants to bless somebody, He will not come straight to you. He will come using somebody for your blessing.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
My sister, God bless you, and God will maintain the testimonies that He has started in your life. Hallelujah.
Clap hands for Jesus, somebody.
Hallelujah. Let's welcome Brother Dennis. God spoke a word.